Hi everybody, today I have a quick video about vectors with GeoGebra Geometry. To access GeoGebra Geometry, you can go to the geogebra.org page and then look for the Geometry Calculator. By default, the Geometry page does not have a grid or any axis showing, so you may want to turn those on so that you can kind of tell what you're working with. So I'm going to go to the settings, I'm going to say Show Grid, I like the major grid lines, and then I'm going to go back and say show the axis. The basic tools are very limited, so we're going to open up more tools by clicking on more. And specifically what we're looking for is down in the lines and it says vector. So when you click on vector, you need to give 2 points. So I'm going to give a point at the origin and then I'm going to give a point somewhere else. Let's do a second vector by again, let's click on the origin and then just go somewhere else. If I want to see exactly what the point B, C, and A are, I can go over to Algebra and then click on any of the points. So I'm going to click on B and it shows me it's 4.8 and 2.99. If I would like those to be integer values, I could just type on top and say, let's go to 5.3 and maybe same thing for C. Let's say, let's make that -4 and then how about 2? Now I have these nice little values. Not only did GeoGebra give a name to the point that we used, it also named the vector. So I have a vector that starts in A, goes to B, that's my vector U, and then I have a vector V that goes from A to C. If you want the names of the vectors to show up on the graph, then you can go to the settings, and then where it says show label, it'll show the name. So now you can see I have U on my vector U. Let's do the same thing for V. So settings, let's show label, and now I can see both vectors. Because it's a calculator, we can do operations. So say we want to do the dot product, u times v, I can put it in, u times v, and it says -14. I can also find the angle between the vectors. To do that, I go back to my tools, and what I'm looking for here is measure. So I want to measure an angle. The angle I want to measure is A, so I want to go from the point B to the vertex A, and then over to C. When I do that, it'll give me the measure of the angle, and you can click and drag the numbers around. Sometimes it might take more than one click to make sure you're clicking on the right thing, but you can move the angle so you can see it. What's also nice is once you have this all done, you can change the values. You can change the values by going back to algebra, and then picking the point and maybe changing the point value. That will update the dot product, and it will also update the angle. You could also go back to the tools and go to move. On move, you can go over to a point and then actually move the point. As you move the point, you can see the degrees changing, and then if we had the algebra pane open, we would also see the dot product changing as we move this point. GeoGebra can additionally do addition and subtraction for vectors. If I put in u plus v, it gives me a vector, and when I hit enter, it'll show you that it labeled it w. We can put that in the settings to have it label it as well. And then if we wanted to move it, you can see that all the things are moving. So vector v moves, vector w moves. You could also do u minus v. This will again label the vector, and if you want to see the label, you go back to the settings and click Show Label. If you find your graph is getting too crowded, you can always turn things off by unclicking them so you can see only the vectors you want to view. One last thing is I want to show you, you can do scalar multiplication. So say I want to do 5 times u. I write 5 times u, it gives me this extended vector, which is -10, -10. And I could kind of move around so you can see this elongated vector that we get by doing scalar multiplication.